Abide in Jesus, and ye shall receive power. This is your daily devotional reading.
Gifted through the Spirit, July 27th. Pastors and teachers to pursue unity. And he gave some apostles, and some prophets, and some evangelists, and some pastors and teachers for the perfecting of the saints, for the work of the ministry, for the edifying of the body of Christ, till we all come in the unity of faith and of the knowledge of the Son of God, unto a perfect man, unto the measure of the stature of the fullness of Christ. Ephesians 4, verses 11 through 13. The Lord hath given to those who should be his human agents talents of means, capacity, and influence, according to their ability to employ these gifts in a wise manner for his service. He has given to every man his work. And he gave some apostles, and some prophets, and some evangelists, and some pastors and teachers. Why were these various workers appointed? For the perfecting of the saints, for the work of the ministry, for the edifying of the body of Christ, till we all come in the unity of the faith and of the knowledge of the Son of God, unto a perfect man, unto the measure of the stature of the fullness of Christ, that we henceforth be no more children, tossed to and fro, and carried about with every wind of doctrine, by the sleight of men, and cunning craftiness, whereby they lie in wait to deceive, but speaking the truth in love, may grow up into him in all things, which is the head, even Christ. Ephesians 4, verses 12 through 15. We can see from this scripture that the Lord has his appointed workers, and that the work committed unto them has in view a definite object. Prophets, apostles, evangelists, pastors, teachers are all to work for the perfecting of the saints, for the work of the ministry, for the edifying of the body of Christ. Is not this object worthy of careful attention? Can we not discern that there has been neglect in some special work for the church, in that the saints have not attained the perfection that God would have them attain? Had the work of the ministry been done, the church would have been edified and educated for the great work that devolves upon them. The truth would have been presented in such a way that the Spirit of the Lord would have moved upon hearts, and sinners would have been convicted and converted, and would have taken their position as followers of Christ. Gifted through the Spirit, July 27th.